Let us offer our consecration to the Lord. Lord, we offer up to you this day, and we ask that you give us the wisdom and the strength to live the faith we are called to live, especially during these times. You have called us to live these times so that we may live our faith as you call us to live. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Well, today is, in fact, July 20th, which is also Wednesday of the 16th week of Ordinary Time. Kind of an interesting day if you really think about it, because here we are looking at these, kind of building on what I said yesterday, we're looking at these ancient scriptures. Among the things we will see today is the call of Jeremiah, which happened roughly, not quite, but almost 3,000 years ago. So we have the call of Jeremiah, and so you have that almost 3,000 years ago. And also in this day is the anniversary of man landing on the moon. So you see these two exact powerful events that reflect this powerful history of the human race. And now, obviously, around this time, we now have this telescope which gives these beautiful images well into the deepest parts of space. And we see these images and, you know, we can see them, you know, look them up on this day, the anniversary of man landing on the moon. And at the same time, we can look back and see these readings, which bring us the understanding, as I said yesterday, there's science and there's faith. They aren't competitors. They work together. And faith deals with those things that are of the spiritual world as well as those things that are of the material world. Science works just with those things of the material world. And remember, science gives us facts and helps us to understand more the world by trying to more understand more facts. But the facts don't help us when what is needed is love. And that's where it is. And remember what I said yesterday. I mean, if you really look at something that's really important, you have these scientific regimes, and you saw one with Hitler, who had all the facts, but he had no love, and he hated the Jews, according to Dennis Prager, because he also hated the Ten Commandments, which is all about love. So we see these whole dynamics come together, that faith and science come together because faith is all about love and doing love in a world rooted in facts. I guess that's a way to put it. That's not some, some profound statement someone made. That's just a simple statement I just made. But that's important. Remember, what is the thing that we're called to do as people of faith? Love. Love God, love neighbor. Does science teach that? No. Do we need science? Absolutely. Every element of it. But we need it with faith so we can understand how to love. And one of the things I said in the afternoon show, which is important to understand, is science or reason without faith brings you the Holocaust. Faith without reason brings you the Inquisition. So as you see, you need this intense balance. Well, one of the things we're seeing in the first reading is the call of Jeremiah, as I mentioned. This is where the famous line is from chapter 1, verse 5. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. And I want you to think about that yourselves, because you say, well, I'm not Jeremiah. No, you're not. Neither am I. But one of the things to see is the Lord has that vocation that he calls you or called you or is calling you to, and whatever vocation that is, doesn't necessarily mean to the priesthood. A lot of times when people hear the term vocation, they think of priesthood. No, but there's also the vocation to married life. There's also the vocation to being a single person. And there's also the vocation to religious life. But you can look at where the Lord is guiding you. And always think of something else. Your element and who you truly are affects humanity in almost in the tiniest ways, because you affect somebody who affects somebody who affects somebody. And there is that effect that happens all the way down the way. And so you're playing an important role in the history of humanity, Because the Lord wants you to do that at this time. It doesn't mean you have to go create great things. It just means you have to be who you're called to be. And in doing so, you will do powerful things. I guess it comes down to that famous concept of the butterfly effect, which is that, say, for example, you were transported back in time and there was a butterfly in your way. This is off the top of my head, but I know the general effect. There's a butterfly and you killed the butterfly because it was in your way. And that just changed the whole course of history in a tiny way that, you know, basically snowballed to a bigger way. Well, always think of that within the context of your life or someone that you're dealing with who is at the end of their life. They did powerful things. They did wonderful things for which they know nothing, probably, but you have no idea. They may have, you know, said, they may have hypothetically smiled to someone who is deeply, deeply depressed, and that smile may have changed their ability to make it through the day that they didn't have until that point, and then things changed after that. We don't know. But do know that the Lord called you at your baptism. And at your baptism, he called you to live the vocation, but that doesn't necessarily mean you know all the things he has called you to do, which in fact you may have done, but you didn't necessarily see them. We'll talk more on the other side of the break. You're listening to St. Anthony Overnight from St. Anthony Parish in Alston, Massachusetts, right here on WEZE. I want to call your attention to Catholic TV, which offers great faith-filled, family-friendly programming 24 hours a day. You can find your cable channel at www.getcatholictv.com, and you can watch online on the free apps or check out the YouTube channel. Daily Mass, Rosaries, the Divine Mercy Chaplet, and the Our Lady of Perpetual Help Novena are all available online and on demand. Check out CatholicTV.com. And don't forget our own website, CatholicAudioMedia.com. That's CatholicAudioMedia.com. Check out our website. Check out the archives of the show. Check out our Substack newsletter. You can check out all kinds of things over there at CatholicAudioMedia.com. That's CatholicAudioMedia.com. And don't forget, you have a standing invitation to come worship at our parish at 10 o'clock in the morning on Sunday morning. So come by and worship with us and help us to build the parish. Help us to really set up the parish and really build it to be a parish for the 21st century. So if you want to be part of that, come and do that. So we are talking about different things in light of who we are and what we are all about. And one of the things we were just talking about is the call of Jeremiah. Well, in the gospel, we're seeing Jesus talk about that parable of the sower who went to sow. And I could do a whole book on the parable. But if we look at one of the most important things, and that is the seed falls among the thorns, and the thorns grow up, and they choke it. And we understand later, I guess that'll probably be explained tomorrow in the gospel, but I could explain it today. We always understand what that is the anxieties of the world and the temptations of the world. Well, do understand that it is a powerful teaching of the church, that of Christ himself, that he does not want us to be lost in anxiety. And when we are lost in anxiety, and I know there are a lot of people who suffer from it, including myself, what we're called to do is bring everything to prayer and to trust in the Lord. That is in so many saints' writings, in so much. But we forget that the anxiety is something that the Lord wants to lead us away from. He wants us to give our life to him and to trust in him and to trust that he will resolve these issues that we deal with in our lives. And that's so important. One of my favorite sayings, which I'm going to encourage you to go look up, I don't have it in front of me right now, although I have it to memory, is Sirach chapter 2. It's in a Catholic Bible. It's not in a non-Catholic Bible, but it's in a Catholic Bible. Sirach chapter 2. And you will see, especially 1 through 11, where there's this powerful message of to trust in the Lord. My son, when you come to serve the Lord, prepare yourself for trials. Be sincere of heart and steadfast, undisturbed in times of adversity. So keep that in mind. I mean, that's one of the teachings. And then it says that these difficult times that you may be going through are like fire that test and purify gold. That is also an ancient symbol in the church, that in Judaism too, that our difficulties are those things that lead us closer to Christ, because what they do is they are like fire that purify gold. And as you know, that gold gets purified, it becomes more valuable. So we understand that. So it's to bring, it's always an essential element. As Jesus says, you know, you have the anxieties and you have the temptations. The important thing is to bring those things to the Lord, always in your prayer. Some people will say, if I have committed a mortal sin, can I still pray? Absolutely. That's actually when you should pray even more, because that's essential. The, you know, if you build into the idea that if you've committed a mortal sin, you might as well just give up on praying, then guess what? You're going to commit more mortal sins, and you're going to cut yourself off from the Lord. So always, yes, as a matter of fact, you should pray more, and obviously go to confession. And one of the powerful things of confession is that it destroys the effects of mortal sin, but it also restores your relationship with Christ, and it builds and strengthens you even more and gets rid of all those thorns, as we see in today's gospel. We'll talk more tomorrow. In the meantime, have yourself a blessed day. If you would like to support our program, please consider a donation to St. Anthony Parish in Allston, Massachusetts. There are several ways to consider this. One is to purchase any of our merchandise, which you can find at the shopping tab at catholicaudiomedia.com. That's catholicaudiomedia.com. There are coffee mugs there. There's also my latest book, Encounter Christ in Your Humanity, all of which you can find at the shopping tab at catholicaudiomedia.com. You can also donate to the show directly through either the Donate tab, also at CatholicAudioMedia.com, or by sending a donation through the U.S. Postal Service with your questions and comments at 43 Holton Street, Allston, Massachusetts, 02134. That's St. Anthony Parish, 43 Holton Street, Allston, Massachusetts, 02134. Finally, the best way you can support our parish is to attend Mass on Sundays at 10 o'clock and be a part of our parish. We thank you for any support you would like to give to St. Anthony Parish in Allston, Massachusetts, the sponsoring parish for this media outreach to Catholics and other Christians in the WROL, WEZE, and podcast listening audience. In Cristo vivimos.